Right, folks. Just gonna set the camera up the zoom here. There we go. So I'm gonna try and do a live video of how to carve this woman's face. And first I'm gonna draw it onto the wood. So first what I do is trying to get the zoom good. There we go. Hope everybody's keeping alright. Carving away. Right, so first when I'm putting these faces on, what I'll do is I'll start at the front top of the head and just do that, see that shape? So I'll just copy it over to here rough because it's just for a, just a rough, this is just for rough for looking at, like it doesn't have to be perfect. And then I'll see that shape comes here, this bit comes down like at that angle, so I'll bring that down at that angle. Sort of curl it around a bit. And it sort of comes in. Goes down. Doesn't have to be perfect. Right, now we're around to the wee lip. Bit from the lip. So I'm going to add the lip bit until it. I'm going to try and just get it done here while I can. Right, now follow this wee line down the side here. Wee bit in the middle. Bring it up a bit. And then down onto this lip. So there's a wee gap in the middle there. And then put the bottom lip on. And then it goes down and around that chin here. So I'll have a wee look at the comments. Alright guys, hope it's keeping alright. I'll have a wee look at the comments here in a wee minute. I'm just focusing on this. So we're down to the bottom of the chin, and then that bit sort of comes up into a corner. That chin needs to be out a bit more. So you can see there, that's just sort of rough. And the bottom of the neck comes down the way. I'm going to just give her a hood, rather than putting her onto it. Top of head comes around, I guess. So make it look like she has a hoodie. Zoom this out a wee bit. There we go. So I've got this rough bit on and I'll see where the nose is. Just stick a wee bit in there, a wee mark for the nose. And then the back end of the nose looks like it comes around like that. My lip's a bit big. That's alright, it's just rough. So then I'll follow the nose up. And see level where the nose is, where the top of the eye would be here. So I'll try and zoom it in. So I'll sort of just look roughly up, the nose comes up a bit. Where the distance is for the middle of the eye. So it's about there. And then just see where that wee bit is on it. That's the start of the eye, so you can start it about there. Bring that in for the shadow. That's for this shadow bit here. And then under it, halfway along the shadow, comes down the eye. So roughly that's where the eye should be. Stick the bottom of the eye on, and then the front should be about here. And there's a wee line under the eye, so that's just rough. Here, just have a get the eye onto it. Then up from the eye, see where the shadow is here. Go up this shadow and there's where the eyebrow would start there, sort of. So just whack in a wee bit of eyebrow. That's just to get us a rough face there. So there we go. This back bit, I'm just going to leave this a natural wood. I'm going to make it look like it, like she has a hood on. So that's pretty much how I would get the trunk or get the face on to here. This side of it, you could do her coming off this or whatever here, but I'll cut around the outside of it first and I'll keep it going. Hope everybody's keeping all right. That's it on pretty rough now. So what I can do is just take a marker. And we'll just run over the outline. Just outline define it a wee bit. Try and fix the zoom. There we go. And then I can just look at this now. Come down it with a pen. Just sort of rough. Give it a shape. You can see that wee bit comes in a bit, so. And that's a bit of the middle of the mouth. That's the bottom lip sets out a wee bit. There we go. I could bring that up a wee bit further. And I'll put the hood on. And this will be the bottom of the neck. And see if I do the wee nose hole in there. There we go, that's not too bad for starters. And then the eye. Just define the front of the eye. There we go. There's a wee bit under the eye, I'll put that wee marker. And then the cheek sort of runs down. Level that corner of the nose there, so. That's looking alright. So there we go. I'll stick the eyebrow on top. At the top. There we go. That'll do for now, and then I can just get whacking away here because I want to get it done. That would be like a hood coming up over a tab. So there we go, guys. I've got the cuts all on. Extreme flame bar. And I'm going to just start whacking now. I'm going to take away the outside of it. I'm going to cut it as deep as the cuts all bar. So as deep as that goes in. I'm going to get my mask on and blast away. I'm going to just clean down all around the side of it first. Right down to here. And then I'll talk about what way we're going to lower in around the detail pit of the face. So there we go, guys. Hopefully that's all right. I'm trying to just keep it rocking and rolling here. I don't want to waste no time. So hope everybody's keeping good. Get the dust mask on here. Don't want to be choking. Right, all good. Well, maybe just keep that zoom on like that. That's a reference image there. Alright, here we go, guys.
Thank you.
get the dust mask off. Alright, there you go, guys. You can see that. So let's re-brush up. We just cut around the outside of that face. And it's the same deep as the cutsaw bar is wide. See the wide of the bar? That's how deep. Just the same depth as the bar. That's a cutsaw extreme flame bar. Anyone's looking at them there, there's a wee link in the description anyway. But that's it, just cut in rough now. So what it do is now is we come around this line for the top of the hat. Well, it's going to make it have a hood on it. But come around the inside of the hood now. And just separate this bit round. Join it back down onto the neck. And you can see it cut out where the chin. Sorry, cut out where the chin and the neck is here at the bottom. So what I'm going to do is now I'm just going to whack around the top is. But I'm going to change the bar over. I'm going to change this here flame bar. And I'm going to put on the original. I cut all original bar now, because that's just basically the most I'm going to remove. The rest now I can do it with the original cutsaw. There's not a lot to be removed now. It's more just shaping it. So I'll change them over. Stick in the original. It's a bit more smoother. It's not as rough. Still cuts really good. Especially that's nice cedar. So the cedar cuts really easy. There we go. So I'm going to keep it going here. Put the dust mask back on, guys. I'm going to cut out the top of this hood. And then I'll talk about how I would shape around the face. Sort of as I go here. And then hopefully that'll help some people to be able to do a girl's face. Looking that way. And like I say, it's just a wee reference image. Found out on Google. That's the guy's name. Adam Breen Art. If you're looking for him. And if anybody's trying to find images for when you're looking for a good image for carving, I'll give you a good wee tip. When you go to Google, if you're looking for a woman's face, search for a woman's face and then put the words tattoo flash, F-L-A-S-H at the end of it, tattoo flash. And that would be the best way for you to get cracker images for your carvings. I definitely recommend getting a black and white image. Because it has the shadows and stuff on it, and the shadows is really good for showing you where you need to carve deeper. So I'll keep it going anyway, guys. Get the dust mask on here. And like I say, I'm just using the original flame bar here now. I'm just going to cut the top of the hood out, and then I'll start to just detail the face. There we go, keep it rolling. Right, there we go, guys. So you can see there how much more smoother that is, the original flame burr. The extreme burr leaves wee rip marks in it. That there cleans it up really good. I've just went round, you see now, I just dropped that down a wee bit and just follied the lane round. So what I'm going to do is now, I would look at this here image and then see the way the shadows in here. Well, that bit's definitely a lot deeper on the head here, so that's going to be this part in here. So I'm going to need to deepen that there down and bring it up to where the eyebrow is. And the eyebrow actually sits up higher than obviously the lower part. So I just leave this eyebrow, I'm not going to touch it, and I'm going to lower it down afterwards. So I'm just going to carve this bit of hair deeper and be aware that the eye goes round the way and sort of down here. And then I'll do the same. That there comes in just till about here. So you'll see I'll lower this hair down and then we'll lower the whole front of the head just gently to take that sort of down a wee bit. And the same again, the back end of that there. This needs to be lower here. So we're going to just carve a wee bit out of this. And then the front of that nose needs a wee bit tucked out of there. And then under this lip, to sort of bring the lip up. So I'm going to carve them all out first. And then once I carve them out, I can lower the rest of the face down to just gradually meet it. Same game goes for the cheek. See the part of the cheek here where the shade is. This whole part of the face, I'm hardly even going to touch it. I'll probably not even carve it. This wee bit here, and I'm going to sort of take that down a wee bit. And under the eye a wee bit. And then you'll see that'll give you this dip in here. So then I can just carve that out in line with where the nose joins onto here. So I'm going to do that first here now, just using this here. Just trying to explain what I'm doing. Working with the shadows as I go. So next I'll cut out these shadows here, guys. Sort of trying to define around where the eye is. And under the eye and stuff. And sort of just gives the face a wee bit of definition. So I'll stick a mask back on here. Hope everybody's keeping well. It's good to get back to carving here. I finally get to do these live videos. I thought you needed 1,000 subs to go live. And apparently now YouTube lets you do it if you have more than 50. So happy days. This is my first ever proper live video. I'm just trying to help everybody and show you how I do the a woman's face and a nice wee bit of cedar. So I'll get the mask on here, guys. Keep on going because I'm starting to choke here on the dust. We'll keep her rocking, keep her rolling. Here we go.
Thank you.
Right, there we go, guys. It's starting to take shape now. I just need to grab a pencil. Hope everybody's keeping all right. So, that's pretty much it. Cut out roughly now. Now it's ready to just sort of put the details on it and do the final shaping of it. I'll just get the pencil again and just go around it and just redraw on some of the lines here. Put the nose bit into it. Just redraw it back around the eye again. And I'm going to cut the eye out and cut the shadows and stuff a bit deeper. And I'm going to change the burr over. There we go. And the cheek will come up here sort of, so all in here is going to get lowered. Whole front of the nose needs to get lowered down. Yep, it's taking shape. A wee bit needs lowered into here. And then I'll define around the top of the lip. Put the bit into the middle. And then under the chin. And that's pretty much going to be it done for an eye, like. And then it's ready for sawing it up and cleaning it up. I'm just going to change the bar over now. I'll take that original flame bar off it. I'm going to use these here for people with big massive hands. All the wee small finger people use the wee Dremel parts with it there. So I'll change it over onto the wee sphere bar. And I'll run around, do some and we lost the details, just lowering around the face. That's us. And that's a small sphere. There's two different sizes of them. You can get the bigger sphere bar. That's a wee small one. And that's just the original. Same again, you can find them in the link below. Just in the wee description box. So I'm going to go back to doing this. See there where I've drew on the shadows and stuff. So I'm just going to go around lower them down here. And sort of give it the last wee bit of definition. So here we go. Hope everybody's keeping good. I'll check all these comments when I'm done here because I want to get this done here, guys. I'm running out of time. Yep, keep her going.
Thank you.
Right, guys, I'm gonna do the hair, so I'm gonna keep the dust mask on and get her done here. Hope everybody's all right. I just changed that over to a wee tiny diamond tip, just to do these wee detail cut here and here and in the lip, and then it just needs sand that up. I'm gonna keep her going here. Thank you. Right. Let's simmer it a bit. There we go, guys. I think I'll end the video here now. And hopefully that's helped a few of you. So just how to get at least a bit of a face into the wood. I'll not do no more work on this till the next time. And I'll show you, I'll change it over to a metal working bar in the next video. And I'll clean all that up and then we'll put the hood and all onto it. Maybe give it some hair coming out the side or something, but hopefully that helps some of you out there. That's roughly how to get a woman's face. It's a transfer and on there, it's a flat bit of cedar. And I'll do the details and stuff in it, the proper details into the eyes and stuff in the next video here. And it's just basically a metal working bar over it and then hand sand it. So there you go, guys. And I'm going to have to hit the road here and get stuff moving. But everybody's keeping well. I'll check this wee video later and get a check back at all the comments and stuff. Seen a couple of ones commenting, but I really just wanted to get that done. That's my first live video I got to do, so pretty pleased with that. So all good. Everybody stay creative. And I hope you're all keeping well.